Dr. Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to talk a little bit more about elastics and how the biomechanics differ from using ClearCorrect or Invisalign or some type of clear aligners versus braces. So this is where I kind of get back on my soapbox and I tell you, you're never going to fully be able to master Invisalign, ClearCorrect, or clear aligners unless you understand braces and phase one appliances. It's just how it is. I have now been training doctors for, wow, over 15 years, but full-time for 9 years, general and pediatric dentists. And it just kind of blows my mind the difference in when I educate and work with doctors on their cases, those that have first trained in phase one in braces and then moved on to master aligners versus those that are doing it backwards. It just doesn't work. You guys don't get the concepts. You just won't. It's just like, I mean, it's like, I don't know, I'm trying to think of an analogy, but you know, going to high school and having almost no math background and trying to take calculus, you're not gonna get it. You know, it's just, you think you get it, but you won't get it. So I'm just gonna keep saying, I don't care, even if you don't wanna do it in your practice, at least take the classes and understand the fundamentals, but you really, really won't understand it unless you start doing it, and that's just a fact. But anyways, so I'm gonna talk to you high level on the whole, how we use elastics in braces, or let's rephrase this, how I use elastics in braces, how I was trained, what works for me. And then I'm gonna extrapolate that to aligners. So with braces, I mean, first of all, I've got tons and tons and tons of videos in my Straightwire playlist, and we are actually launching our Straightwire course sometime in the next few weeks. It's now November. I'm hoping it will be launched by December 1st and we will have some awesome promo pricing. It will be on my website. You will, and if you're part of our newsletter, you'll definitely know when it gets launched. But anyways, with braces, we align and level first in our light nighttie wires. We do not close any space in light nighttie wires. We do not use elastics. Okay, class two and class three. We will use posterior box elastics for deep bites. Or for high canines, light ones in light nighttie wires. But basically for most patients, you're not even getting into class two, class three elastics until later, the second half of your treatment. So that's after we've worked our way up, after we've worked our way through our 12s, our 14s, our 16s, our 18s, and we're probably not using all those wires. But you know, at least up to 18 nighttie passive, taking a progress pano, doing our repositions if we need them, which you shouldn't need to do if you're doing indirect bonding. And putting your brackets on right to begin with. And then we move our way up to the heavier nighttie wires, possibly steel, sometimes yes, sometimes no, it depends on the situation. And then come the class two and class three elastics as needed. Remember, elastics do not grow jaws. I can't say that enough times, they do not grow jaws. If you wanna grow a jaw, you have to use an appliance that grows a jaw. That means you have to use your Invisalign with MA, you have to use a twin block, you have to use a binary, you can use a forces, you can use a herbst. I'm not a big fan of those ladders just because of the damage they can cause. But anyways, elastics tip teeth, can't occlusal planes get teeth to match up a little bit more. And if there are spaces that have been created or exist, if you have the correct anchorage, elastics can help close the space in a positive direction to help make the case class one if you're doing things properly. That's how elastics work, okay? So, and also if you have impacted molars, wisdom teeth, elastics are not gonna work as efficiently. So it's always a good idea to get those suckers out before you use your class two, class three elastics. Okay, so that's braces, elastics in a nutshell for class two, class three, okay? Let's talk about aligners. This is the mistake I see so many of you guys throwing elastics on your cases. I'm like, why are you putting elastics on the case? This is gonna do nothing. All it's gonna do is actually make your case go worse. And again, this is my opinion because I've probably seen 10, 20, 30, 40, 50,000 aligner cases. I don't even know, it could be 100,000, a ridiculous amount. I see dozens a day, you know, for 20 years, it adds up. Do the math, I don't know, maybe it's less. But I sometimes see more than dozens a day. I see a ridiculous amount of aligner cases, high level, you know. But I also have the beauty of some, a lot of my clients I'm with, besides the cases I've done, the clients I'm with, some of them 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, long time. Some of them, I can't get rid of you guys. You're awesome. You don't want to get rid of me. So they just like to have me around just in case they have a question. So I get to see these patients a couple years later and I feel even more confident about my methods that they work. So aligners, treat them the same way you do braces. Don't throw past. I know you guys think that you're gonna do one and done Clincheck, but on a complicated case, that's class two or class three, don't throw elastics on at the beginning. Occasionally I will. especially if I'm doing sequential, a major sequential distalization case, like a heroic one, we're talking like 8 millimeters on the top or 3 millimeters on the bottom. Yeah, I'm gonna do elastics for anchorage. I mean, the beauty of aligners is that you have so much more control over your anchorage. So it's really, really easy to do beads on a string and slide those teeth one at a time backwards. If you have a case like this, let's say this case was, I think this case actually is class three. Let's say we take these eights out, the bone heals a little bit, and then we start scooting these suckers back one at a time, one at a time. You don't really need the elastics to correct it. But in braces, you can't really do that. So yeah, you need the elastics. So you need a lot fewer elastics in Invisalign, ClearCorrect, SureSmile, Spark, Reveal, I don't care, Global, whatever company you're using, than you do. And that's one of the beauties of aligners, is that you have so much more control over everything. That's why I love them so much, especially on open bite cases, especially on high angle cases. I love aligners so much more. Deep bite cases, a few cases where I think braces work better, few situations, but it's getting to be less, fewer and fewer, where I think braces are superior to aligners. The vast majority, I think aligners is faster, healthier, quicker, better for the teeth, better for the gums than braces, and you get a better outcome quicker in the right hands. Anyways, so no elastics. And the other thing is, you never, ever, ever want to hook the elastics onto the plastic. That's the dumbest thing ever. All it does is affect the tracking, okay? It pulls, you're trying to keep this aligner always seated and engaged, and then this is pulling it off. It's a counterforce. Why? That makes no sense. Always use buttons. Always, always, always glue buttons on the teeth if you're trying to do it. Elastics can cant the occlusal plane. So if you have a situation and you got to think about, this is why you have to take a Ceph, or at least a sagittal slice in these type of AP sagittal cases where you're like, okay, it's a little class two, it's a little class three. I'm just trying to get that last millimeter or two of jump the bite, fix the bite, last couple of millimeters. Okay, think about how elastics work, right? If I'm starting out, let's say a class two case, let's say there's a class two case that already has procline upper incisors. Class two case that already has retroclined upper incisors and procline lower incisors. Am I getting this right? I had to think about this for a second. Yes. Then the elastics are not going to do that much, because that's what the elastics would do. They're going to go ahead and cant it in the direction that you're doing it. Well, that's not going to work. But if I had a class two case that had flared upper incisors and retroclined lower incisors, okay, then that might work out. That might be a good choice for elastics. And the opposite with class three, right? If I already have retroclined lower incisors, right, and proclined upper incisors, flared upper incisors, there's no sense in using the class three elastics. It's not going to do anything. It's not going to, unless you're creating space. But if you're creating space with aligners, there, it doesn't do anything anyways, because I can just use my sequential distalization or sequential mesialization to fix the bite. So if you're not understanding every little thing I'm saying, then you're not ready to take hard aligner cases. And that's what I'm getting at. I'm talking kind of high level. If you don't understand every single word of what I'm saying, you need to go back and do braces 101. You need to go back and do phase one ortho 101. And then you're going to understand everything I'm saying. And then your aligner cases will make sense to you. You'll be able to get excellent, excellent outcomes. And I just got to say it again, if you do not have a Ceph machine, you do not have a CBCT that takes sagittal slices, you got to have one or the other if you're going to take hard aligner cases. You're going to have to sometimes take them. And it's not always at the beginning. Sometimes you're going to have to take it in the middle. You're checking on something, you know, like, what's going on? This is weird. Let's take a progress x-ray and see what's going on. We need to go take a progress sagittal slice. Let's see how those incisors are. What's going on? What's happening? You got to have a way to do that if you're going to take the harder cases. If you're going to punt all the harder cases, no problem, then I don't care, as long as your state doesn't require it and I don't memorize all the dental practice acts. So, all right. So anyways, that was a big diatribe today. Hopefully you learned something new. Take care.